Hey, hi guys, welcome to the Quant Lab. The Quant Lab mein aapka swagat hai. In this video, I am going to be talking about more than 15 libraries that can help you in getting started with algo trading. These are different libraries, so watch the video till the end. I'm going to be talking about libraries which are core finance driven, core into trading, core into machine learning, core into visualization, and tons of different stuff. Let's get started. So the first library we have is NumPy, and NumPy is really famous. If you want to do any array operation, vectorization, and numerical computation, NumPy is the benchmark. This is probably the underlying data structure that most of libraries used when they interact with arrays and div vectors and stuff like that. Really must to know and very foundational. So number one, NumPy. Number two on the list is Pandas, and Pandas is really a very open library which is intended for data and manipulation. You can use it to, you know, read data, write data, perform operations, do filtering, do sorting and stuff like that. And Pandas is also equally popular as NumPy, probably another library which you must be aware of. Now I'm going to get into some core finance driven library. Yahoo Finance, very important. You have its parallel in the form of Alpaca, which is also a very similar library. I'm not talking about that in this video, just giving a reference. But when you have something like Yahoo Finance, you use it for getting data in and out, not really out, in for different time periods into your code and reading historical data. Point to remember, Yahoo Finance only gives you historical data. It's not going to help you give real-time market inputs. All right. Next up on the list is TA-Lib, where you have an exhaustive list of technical indicators. As it says, TA-Lib, which is technical analysis library, and you have close to 150 to, I think it's 200 indicators plus. They have candlestick recognition patterns. You have the most common ones like Bollinger Band, stochastic, and tons of different stuff. The library is really, really old and very stable. The calculations are really fast and most of them are vectorized, so you can use them without any hiccups or performance loss. Moving forward, the first library on the list that belongs to the category of machine learning, and scikit-learn, or sklearn as it's more nicely called, is a very big library. It has classification, regression, clustering, dimensionality reductions, and all sorts of different operations that you can do when you want to achieve a machine learning problem. And with trading, you can definitely apply machine learning in it. So you would use it for feature engineering, you would use it for maybe forecasting, you would use it for even some sort of small scale plotting. So sklearn is extremely important library if you want to get started with machine learning into trading or algo trading, and that's it. Moving forward, Backtrader. Backtrader is a library which allows you to really write very optimal code, and it's intended for backtesting, as the name says. So you can get started very quickly. I have done videos using these libraries. Most of these have been used in my previous videos. So if you're new to my channel, please subscribe to the channel. Watch some of the previous videos to get more content. If you are a returning customer, thank you. Please do, and thumbs up. Sorry, I use the word customer. I don't know why. Subscriber, somebody who likes to listen to me. All right. Backtesting.py, very similar library, but like Backtrader, but I prefer it over Backtrader because this is much more simple and has very easy APIs, and you can get started in this much more easily. So very similar libraries, but I would say this is good to begin. Pyfolio is another library which is intended for, it's a library which is intended for performance analysis, and you can use it for gaining some sort of risk scores, evaluation of strategies and stuff like that. So this can give you a lot of different data points for doing analysis on top of your strategies or your portfolio and stuff like that. Zipline is also a library which is very Pythonic and event driven, and this has been used for backtesting and live trading. I think this has some integrations which the previous libraries do not have, like machine learning integration and stuff like that. Really popular library. Previously it was very popular, but now I think some of the support has reduced in this, but maybe they are coming up with a newer version. Statsmodel, going back to the libraries which help you achieve in some form machine learning. Statsmodel would probably fit the bill, not so much as a machine learning library, but rather a library for statistical modeling. So if you want to do usual ARIMA time series modeling, or you want to do assessments, Statsmodel is your place. Any sort of data set estimate analysis, any sort of the bell curve analysis or distribution analysis, probability analysis and stuff like that, you can rely on Statsmodel. Two libraries which are India specific. First is called PyKiteConnect. So if your broker is Zerodha, you can use this and connect with Python. So this does support live data streaming and stuff like that. Yeah, not much to talk about more than that. dhanhq is very similar. This is for people who are working with dhan. I am probably going to be doing a video around this as to how to use dhanhq, because this is free and Zerodha actually has charges. So yeah, this is another of broker libraries. Going back to machine learning libraries, TensorFlow, very popular and a Google product, known across and widely respected for an end-to-end machine learning platform. This is not just for algo trading, but if you are getting into advanced algorithms, deep learning and stuff like that, you'll probably stumble upon it. Its peer or competitor, whatever you want to call it, PyTorch, another library which does very similar stuff as TensorFlow, but I think researchers prefer this because of ease and simpler APIs. Just a 2-cent overview about these libraries. Both of these are extremely detailed and the complexity is high, so there's a fair amount of learning curve. So don't assume that you would get something within 2 days or 3 days. It would take some time to get a hang of the libraries. You'll need to understand the algorithms. You'll need to understand and work with dependencies, and these libraries are huge. And sometimes it's also difficult to install them on different ecosystem. Like I have a Mac, Apple Silicon, and it was quite challenging to install initially. These days it has become much more simpler. Moving forward to some libraries which can help you do time series forecasting. FB Profit is very popular. You can obviously use the previous ones that I've talked, but FB Profit is very popular. Nextar is another library, or rather a company, I think, which does a lot of forecasting related stuff. So you have stats forecast, neural forecasts, which are like cutting edge algorithm types. There's ML based forecast, hierarchical forecast, transfer learning based time series model. So anything to do with time series and stuff, Nextar is very popular and very good. The last two, or rather three, libraries on the list, I will say the first one is Matplotlib, which is the gold standard for plotting and charting in Python. So if you are not familiar with it, this is also something you should definitely get familiarization. Seaborn is another library for charting and plotting, but it has nicer and cleaner chart. One library which I forgot to include in my list before, and I'll probably do it right away, is vectorbt. It is probably the most complete package in my view. So accidentally I ended up saving the best for the last. This is probably the most complete, as I was just saying. It has all sorts of integration. It integrates to Plotly, which is probably one of the best looking libraries for visualization. It integrates with visualization tools. It integrates for machine learning libraries. You have pretty much all the features that you would require in a library to perform trading. So you have Pandas integration, you have different technical indicators baked out into it. I think this library further relies on some of the champions of this space, but what they have done is they have made the APIs very easily. So you can, for instance, do SMA or SMA indicator using TA-Lib, but here you can just call vbt.ta and it will give you that. It's probably relying under the hood on those libraries, but they have made it really nice. You have tons of stuff for signal processing, modeling, analysis, plotting, and a lot of extras. It is important to say that this also has a paid version, which is even higher than this. I have not used it. I have only used the free version, so I would probably only be able to talk about that. But in case you want to go much more deeper, and if you're looking for one single shot library that can help you achieve most, this is probably the library I'll recommend. It has a very steep learning curve, I'll say, and in my experience, the installation hasn't been that clean. I've always stuck at some sort of a dependency error or something like that. When you work with this library, make sure you have a completely clean environment. Alright, that's it for today. If you're listening to the video till the very end, this is Diwali week in India. So happy Diwali. Bye-bye, everyone.